The very fact that you clicked on this video says that you want to know more about migraine, friends. Well, if you suffer from frequent headaches, don't worry, you're not alone. Millions all over the world suffer from migraine, a type of headache which is very, very common. In fact, headache is one of the commonest causes of a doctor's visit. What causes headache? What are the trigger factors for development of a migraine headache? Let's have a look in this video. Hello friends, welcome to Doc Logs. I am Dr. Arun Naik, a doctor for 30 years and a neurosurgeon for 20 years now. Dialogue with your doctor is called a Doc Log. In this channel, we have Doc Logs related to brain and heart health, lifestyle diseases, cancer, spine health, and preventive health. We also give here simple, effective tips and tricks to put you on the positive side of your health. Everything told in this video can be found in the description box below. Go check those out if you need more info. With that said, let's get started. Migraine is a common type of recurring headache mostly seen in women, often starting from teenage. When I was a medical student 3 decades ago, we were taught that changes in the brain's blood flow causes migraine. That 50-year-old theory about migraines suggested that symptoms were possibly due to fluctuations in the blood flow to the brain. There was also a view that bulging blood vessels in the head causes headache. Now, many studies have shown that changes in the blood flow and bulging blood vessels don't start that migraine, but may contribute to it. Friends, chronic migraine or migraines happening on at least 15 days a month is characterized by not only severe throbbing pain, but also many other symptoms that accompany an episode, including symptoms like nausea, vomiting, sensitivity to severe light, sound, smell, touch, and even a tingling, burning sensation in the whole body. What's in the brain that causes such an excruciating storm of events? Well, a migraine typically starts with a trigger, which is an incoming sensory stimulus that wouldn't bother most people, such as walking in the bright sunny day or smelling a strong perfume nearby. But for a migraineur, these stimuli feel like a massive sensory assault. The result? The brain produces an exaggerated counter reaction to the trigger. It does by firing its electrical signal systems. This brain electrical activity causes a change in the blood flow to the brain, which in turn affects the brain's nerves, causing a migraine. Current understanding of migraine pain has moved more towards the source of the pain, as improved technology and research have shown the way for a better view. Today, it's widely shown that there are 2 mechanisms by which a migraine starts. One is electrical and the other one is chemical. Now, electrical theory suggests that migraine pain occurs due to spreading waves of activity by groups of excitable brain cells in a brain part called brainstem. Once activated, these neurons or nerve cells send messages along the trigeminal nerves, a major pain pathway that starts in the brainstem and travels along our face, supplying the teeth, eyes, sinuses, and forehead in addition to blood vessels on the surface of the brain. These blood vessels expand or dilate in response. Now, the second chemical theory shows that our brain also responds to the brainstem activation by releasing chemicals called neuropeptides or neurotransmitters like serotonin, noradrenaline, and prostaglandins. Now, serotonin is a neurotransmitter, a chemical required for communication between 2 nerve cells. It can cause narrowing of blood vessels anywhere in the body. Once released, they travel to the coverings of our brain called the meninges, which results in inflammation and swelling of blood vessels, causing an increase in the blood flow around the brain. So this causes migraine. This is likely the cause of that throbbing, you know, pulsating pain most migraineurs experience during a migraine episode. While the pain may be originating from the surface of brain, we may feel it in our eyes, temple area, neck, you know, face, sinuses, etc. So these neurochemicals can result in causing loss of appetite, nausea, and vomiting. Another peculiar phenomenon happens as a result of this trigger of system, that is skin hypersensitivity. About 80% of my migraine patients report what's called as cutaneous allodynia, or skin pain that causes things like their earrings, necklaces, or neckties and eyeglasses to become painful. Many people even say that their hair hurts, and they open their hair to minimize the pain. This electrical chemical activity then occurs across the brain surface, called like a spreading cortical depression. So this current of the activation moves something like a thunderstorm, you know, rolling from the back to the front of our brain. As it passes over the brain, the blood vessels constrict or narrow, limiting the oxygen flow, causing pain. Studies have shown that the cortical depression may be the reason for those visual auras or prodrome that some people with migraine experience. So these auras include seeing dark or, you know, colored spots, sparkles, or other visual disturbances, including blurred vision and those momentary blindness. So in women, the estrogen levels naturally vary over their life cycle. So with increases during the fertile years and decreases thereafter. So women also experience monthly changes in estrogen levels. Migraines in women are often associated with these fluctuating hormone levels and may explain why women are more likely to have migraines than men. Studies have also shown that when estrogen levels rise and then fall, contractions in the brain's blood vessels may be triggered. Other view is that the lower levels of estrogen make the facial and the scalp nerves more sensitive to pain. Now, what are the migraine triggers? People who get migraines may be able to identify those triggers that seem to kick off the symptoms of a migraine. Some possible triggers include things like stress and other emotions, maybe biological and environmental conditions such as hormonal shifts in the body or exposure to, you know, light or smells. Any kind of a fatigue and changes in somebody's sleep pattern. Some of my patients tell me that even the glaring or flickering lights can induce an attack. Similarly, weather changes, especially those, you know, gloomy, rainy weathers, can cause a headache. So certain foods and drinks can also cause headache. Friends, watch my channel for more information on migraine headache, triggers, treatment, and prevention of an episode. Don't miss a special video on home remedies for migraine to keep that migraine headache out of your life. With that, friends, we have come to the end of this video. Hope you found this video helpful. If you liked it, well, give me a thumbs up. Share this video with your dear and near ones to put them also on the positive side of their health. If you're new here, please consider subscribing to DocLogs. Hit that bell icon to get instant notifications of my future videos. If you think any other trigger induces migraine with you or your friends, please share your thoughts in the comment section below. I'll be back with another interesting DocLog very soon. Till then, feel awesome, live awesome, and take good care of your health.